Hey, it's Ian here, and I'm coming to you from the car because I've been out all day. But overnight, there are some pretty big announcements from Photocana, I believe, over in Germany. So I just want to touch base on ones that interested me. Some good and bad points. Not really many bad points, truthfully, but I want to touch base. Now, the first one is the fact that Panasonic have announced the GH5, the successor to the very popular GH4, which I'm actually coming to you right now. I'm using my GH4. So what's it going to do? Well, it's going to be able to do 4K. It's 60 frames per second, so that's a big jump. It's going to be able to do internal 10-bit 422, which is, I think, is the biggest thing for it. I believe it's going to have a better focusing system, better low-light performance, which is something that the GH4 has lacked in, is its low-light performance. So it's going to be interesting to see how that comes. That's not due out until next year, though. Also on the camera front is Sony, and they announced the brand new A99 Mark II, which will be able to do internal 4K. They say 422, but I'm not sure if that's 8-bit or 10-bit. We're a bit hazy about that. It's a 42 megapixel sensor. Now, it's one I'm very much interested in because I've got an A99. So the fact that there's an A99 Mark II really interests me because I don't like the size of the A7 range. So the A99 suits me better, and it just feels like it's the A7R2 in the bigger frame with using A mount. So yes, it is a brand new A mount system. Now, I'm not sure if that's going to come to Australia because I believe they've dropped A mounts, but I'll wait and see. Hopefully they do, or I'll have to import it overseas because I definitely want to get the A99 Mark II, which is going to do 4K, really good sensor, really good focus system, and it's what I'm really interested in larger size with dual slots, and that's what I'm been holding out for. So I'm excited by that. Though one thing I have noticed, Sony still have not updated the menu system. It's still not touchscreen, and it's still not and to say their menu system needs a pretty big overhaul. That's my only real disappointment with the Sony cameras, especially when the Panasonic and that, they get their menu systems really good. They've got them down pat now. So that's one I'm looking forward to coming out. GoPro have announced the GoPro Session 5 and the GoPro Session, no, not post, or should I say, the GoPro 5 Session and also the GoPro 5 Black. And that's all they're going to do now. They've simplified the system. So basically, the GoPro 5 Session is like an update of the Session, which was very popular, and they're still going to sell that one at $199 US. Now, for $299, they're going to have the GoPro Hero 5, which can also now do 30 frames per second 4K with built-in stabilization, which is something that GoPro have needed for a while. I've been saying that. I also said to a friend of mine, Dan, g'day Dan, is that's what the biggest thing they needed to add to the GoPro range. Now, they've also got the GoPro 5 Black, which basically molds the silver and the black together. It's got a completely new design. It looks more black, finally, a black edition that actually looks black. Well, kind of a grey black, and it has a built-in water resistant, I believe, can go down to about 20 meters shell, and then of course you can buy a whole lot of accessories. And I believe the biggest thing, of course, is that it has stabilization. I don't know what the other features, if it's going to be able to do a higher frame rate, 4K, maybe can do 60 frames, I don't know. I didn't really see much on the 5 Black, but I am interested to see how that goes, and the fact that it's got built-in stabilization is a big plus for the GoPro Hero 5, something that the GoPro Hero 4 really needed. They've fallen behind on that. I think it's a 3-axis or 5-axis stabilization. I don't know the full details on that. Sorry if it keeps going a bit out of focus. That's just the way it is at the moment. And also, GoPro announced their own drone. I think it's the Karma drone, weird name, but I really like the idea. They actually mount the camera at the front of it instead of underneath. It can fold away, so it's easy to transport around, which is really handy there. And the gimbal comes with a 3-axis gimbal, electronic gimbal, can be taken off it and then put onto a handheld thing, which comes with the package, so you can use it then as a handheld gimbal. And you might have seen some videos, those handheld gimbals really make a big difference. So, and the drone looks really good, and the control looks small but simple. It's going to be interesting to see how much it's going to sell for, and that's going to be its biggest point. How much is it going to be compared to things like the DJI Phantom 4s and stuff like that? I'll be interested to see how it is. I think it's going to have to be around the 2000 mark to make it competitive. So we'll have to wait and see how like that. I'm looking forward to that. So yeah, the GoPro 5 Black is definitely on top of my list now, along with that drone, and definitely the A99 Mark II. It's going to be putting down a deposit for it as soon as I can get back up to Brisbane, because I'm not up in Brisbane at the moment. I'm down the Gold Coast all day, which is why I'm doing this video from my car. I drive limousines, in case you're wondering. So there you go, that's just my view. If you've seen it, what were you interested in? The GH5 is very definitely interesting. There was other noteworthy mentions, like Fujifilm announced their new medium format camera, which is looking very interesting. Not much more from the other ones, I haven't really looked, but those are what's interested me. What has interested you? Comment below, let me know. Thanks for watching, guys. See you all later.